Hello and welcome to Portimão. It is round two of MotoGP in 2024, and you join us here at the Algarve International Circuit after a pretty quiet start to life. A huge rain shower yesterday, as Nadia Padovani, whose birthday it was yesterday, complimenti, tanti auguri, I think it is in Italian. Rain shower overnight meant that Moto3, well, it was a write-off. We didn't see a single lap, which was great fun to be in the commentary box for. Moto2 then just about got going. For MotoGP, we're out there with Matt Marquez finishing fastest in the end. But lap times, 3 seconds off of the fastest ever lap we've seen, so around 2 seconds off of the pace. So we do expect those guys to improve quite significantly. We go into the afternoon. Of course, this afternoon is going to be practice. It's timed, meaning that they've got to be inside the top 10 to get themselves automatically in Q2 tomorrow morning. We did start a little bit earlier than normal because we're here by the magnificent 75th anniversary MotoGP sign, where we had the great and the good of MotoGP, Camilo Espeleta, Hervé Poncharal, George Villegas of the FIM, plus all of the team managers and team principals were here celebrating the kickoff of MotoGP in Europe. And with that, the fact that the FIM have got themselves not only a new logo, looks great by the way guys, new hospitality unit. So there were, as I said, the great and good were here and we're hanging around because we're hopefully going to grab a word with Davide Brivio very soon indeed. Interesting, we want to chat with Davide because of course we are here in Portugal. Davide is the team principal of the Trackhouse Aprilia squad and their star man this weekend is Portugal's very own Miguel Oliveira. What can the number 88 do this weekend? Of course, he has plenty to try and fight back over after the infamous incident with Marc Marquez last year where he was taken out during the Grand Prix when he was in real contention to be challenging at the front. Of course, made that mistake late on in the sprint on the final lap, which denied him of podium success as well. So he's definitely got a lot to play for this weekend. And after a difficult pre-season, an opening round of the year where never really got into his rhythm, never really was able to showcase what he's about, you feel this is a massive opportunity for Miguel at a place he loves, of course, was victorious here in 2020, to really kickstart his season. Because, I mean, ever since we were last here at the opening round of 2023, through some real misfortune, injuries that were through no fault of his own, he's really struggled to find any kind of rhythm and hopes were so high that Miguel would be able to move on to the Aprilia, which is a really competitive bike, and be able to challenge right at the front. But that just hasn't materialised through at the start of last year. I mean, well documented, as just said. Incredible amount of misfortune, whether it was taken out here by Mark, which then put him on the sidelines for a bit. Then to get to Jerez and be taken out, well, in an unfortunate incident with Fabio Quartararo, whereas the bottleneck their way into turn two, that caused a serious injury as well. And ever since then, he's just struggled to find his feet. And we saw with Enea Bastianini last year, MotoGP, the way that it is now, you miss 3, 4, 5 rounds through injury, and the goalposts just move time and time again. You come back, you're on the back foot, it's so difficult to find the rhythm and be able to catch up and compete right at the sharp end. So we'll be interesting to chat to Davide Brivio when we can. Don't want to interrupt. He's in full flowing conversation with Alfonso Tomei there, part of the FIM safety commission, who has done a real good job, I have to say, despite the real misfortune this morning because of the rain that came in overnight and the dirty track conditions. Portimão have really improved the safety of this place by quite a lot. We look at the gravel, whether it be the gravel traps themselves actually been made bigger, some new curbs being installed as well. They've done a great job, and frustrated, I'm sure, that overnight rain of biblical proportions really put them on the back foot this morning and they couldn't really do that much about it. But anyway, we've waffled long enough. It looks as though right on crew. Actually, for the first time this year, this is going to be quite nice, actually. I've not had a chance to chat with Davide just yet. Sky Italia trying to dive in. Sandro was,
hi.
How are you, David? I was just saying, Sandro was trying to do me on the brakes there and steal an interview away from you. But anyway, we managed to squeeze in. How are you? I was just saying, first chance to actually say hello in 2024. Great to see you back.
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm happy. Happy to be here. And of course, a lot of work to do. You know, it's a new team. We have many things to fix it and everything. But excited. And I still have a lot of energy to to work. So I really enjoy. That's a lot to do, but it's a nice project. It's a great project. I see a lot of potential, and we need to make Trackhouse growing up.
A big weekend for obvious reasons. In one side of the box, Miguel is going to have a lot of support here, and he's got some revenge to try and have, to try and put the infamous incident of last year behind him. But it's been a difficult start to the year so far for Miguel. How important is this weekend?
Yeah, somehow Portimao comes too early in a season, I think. Even if last year it was a completely new bike and he was brilliant until, of course, he had a crash. But he's trying to adapt to the 24. It's getting better and better. We find something good on the last day of testing. Last weekend in Qatar was a little bit unfortunate. He had the long lap penalty to do on the main race, and I think he could have been probably in the top 10 without that. So, I mean, there is the pace, there is the potential to be good. As I say, a little bit early, but we try to give him what he needs. Because there's no doubt it's very fast here. It's very fast everywhere. It's good. It's a great talent. Here is an important race for him. We have to try to give him the best possible tool.
The track conditions this morning weren't perfect, far from it. So Miguel having that track knowledge, Miguel knowing the place as well as he does that help a little bit? Or because he's on the back foot, did he need that track time?
But I have to say that the track knowledge, I mean, it's not the only one, because it's many riders that comes here in the winter to train and to ride for a few days. So, and also we're racing here for a few years. So anyway, the circuit, it's well known by everybody, I think. Of course, for Miguel, it's a home race. And, you know, in this situation, you always have an extra motivation, which helps. And the condition this morning were, really difficult, because some, of course, wet patches, but also a little bit dirty. Some sand coming into the track. So it's difficult to understand who really pushed, who really took the risk, and who stayed a little bit more safer, let's say. And so we see in the afternoon. We really hope that the condition improve. We did some job, you know, try to set up electronic, try to get first feelings. We tried to do what we could under this condition, and then let's go to the afternoon.
Just finally, not looking too far ahead, but this is a big weekend. Austin is going to be a big weekend as well. I imagine that you guys have got plenty planned. Could you give us some secrets? What can we expect?
No, not a big secret, because it's the first time, and also for Trackhouse, for the older family, and it's they are curious to see. We try to invite some staff, some colleagues there. I mean, it's not a secret, but it's like there is a NASCAR race which is in Texas the same weekend. So we might have some NASCAR colleagues coming and visiting us on Friday and Sunday probably. We will start maybe try to mix in the two worlds.
Very nice. We look forward to it. And one of the track houses, Daniel, my track NASCAR knowledge isn't great, but he won last time out, right? By nothing.
Yeah, Daniel Suarez, the 99 car. Now I'm becoming,
you're a fan
more
now.
Information. And now he won in Atlanta for 0.003. And it was great. Yeah, it was great. Great win. But Trackhouse is race winner also last year. Both driver won races. So it's good. So they're making pressure on the MotoGP team, because we also have to do good here. So that's great. That's great.
Davide, great to see you. Enjoy the weekend.
Thank you. Enjoy. Let's everybody enjoy the weekend.
Okay? Absolutely. Thank you to Davide. Great to be able to chat away. And looking forward to chatting away, hopefully, and inside the paddock to some NASCAR drivers then in Austin. Daniel Suarez, as he was saying, victorious in Atlanta. I don't know if it's the right one, but I was chatting to Justin Marks, who is the owner, and one of the drivers, their big celebrations is they smash a watermelon. So I don't know if we're going to see Miguel win this weekend and maybe smash a watermelon as well. Let's see. Interested to meet them as well as the two worlds combine. Great to see the Trackhouse influence is slowly but surely filtering in to MotoGP, and hopefully they can bring with them plenty of NASCAR fans. If there's going to be a few in Texas, and if you haven't got your tickets already, then come along. Why not experience the Circuit of the Americas like many are going to be doing? In terms of the championship picture then, it is, of course, Pekka Bagnaia that leads the way at the moment. 31 points to his name after that impressive start to life in Qatar. And there's a lot of talk already about him, about Ducati, about who's going to end up where and when 2025, given the fact that Fermin Aldeguer was confirmed to be part of the Ducati family, to be moving to the team next door to Prima Pramac Racing, means that already the wheels are in motion of who's going to go where in 2025. That the three big players, you feel, are Jorge Martin, Marc Marquez and Fabio Quartararo. Fabio spoke yesterday and said he wants to make his decision soon. Doesn't want to be waiting months. Doesn't want it to become a distraction. The talk is that potentially Aprilia at this current moment may be the most favoured destination for him. That's just rumours. I'm going to be in pit lane later and I'm hoping that I can grab Massimo Rivola and put that to him to see if he's got anything to say about that. For Jorge Martin, Davide Tardozzi spoke during that first session and said, Jorge wants to stay with us. We want to keep Jorge. We've invested 4 years into him and look at the growth that he's made. Look at the rider that he's become. It would be an awful shame, having done all of that development, for him then to go to another factory and to take benefit there. So maybe we'll see him promoted up to the factory Ducati squad next year. I mean, Jorge, unsurprisingly, has made no secret about the fact that that's where he wants to end up. And then the question is, where does Andrea Bastianini go? Where does Marc Marquez go? Are they going to want to move on to satellite machinery? Are they going to look for a factory ride? There's a lot up in the air at this current moment. And even though we're at round two, already the wheels are in motion and the rumour mill is starting to swirl. And I, for one, really enjoy that. That's what gets me going. I love a good rumour. This man, I'm sure, is going to be hard at work as well. This is Diego Lacave, who's the manager of Fabio Di Giannantonio, who, of course, left it late to get his job done and get his spot on the grid for 2024. Maybe he's in talks already. Who knows? It certainly is an interesting time of year and one where I feel like I'm in my pomp. I'm ready to go. And look at this as well. Here's a little tale for you. So this gentleman here, the Hulk Hogan lookalike, he is like a, this is a paddock secret for you. So just to my right, let's do it secretly. This gentleman right here, he's like an unofficial bodyguard for Marc Marquez. So he was outside the Repsol Honda garage in the last few years. And he sort of just stands and he just slowly and surely and with a measured approach, just make sure that Mark's looked after and he's okay. In fact, let's just grab a word with him, actually. Hello, sir. How are you? All good? No. Oh, he's hard at work. Not at the moment. He's busy doing his bodyguard duties. We won't bother him any further. Look at that. He's fully focused, is that man. And I, for one, as a 5'6". Now, I won't say scrawny, but I need to get in the gym. That is a large human being, and I am not going to be messing with him. So, good luck to him and his bodyguard duties over the rest of the weekend. If anybody was coming and thinking of saying anything untowards towards Mark, then, I mean, obviously, we completely condemn that. Please do not do that. But just so you know, he's waiting, he's watching, and he might pounce. So there we go. That's like a little paddock secret for you. There's some real characters here. There really are. Right. We've had a waffle. We've had a chat. Great to catch up with Davide Brivio. As we go into Europe, often, as you see, the race trucks are back. All of the team hospitality units are back. So we wait to get the camera sorted. Where we go? Are we there? Do I need to go this way? I feel like I'm the Leaning Tower of Pisa here. Have we got it, guys? Yep. All good? Before we say goodbye? Do I need to just lean a little bit? I think we're sorted, just about, to try and get the gimbal sorted. I mean, technology is great sometimes, but also not great. There we go, we've got it. We've gone the DIY way, just hold it up. But anyway, we won't keep you much longer. The technology is failing, so we'll wish you a goodbye and say, please do join us for MotoGP practice later on. The phone's going everywhere. What a disastrous way to end. But this is typical of Inside the Paddock. It's off script. It is as raw as you like. And sometimes things go wrong, but that's life. That is life. Things went wrong this morning. Moto3 wanted to get some laps in. They couldn't. It was dirty. But luckily, things will be sorted. Tomorrow, we'll learn from this. We'll be better this afternoon. things will be better. We'll see flying laps. We'll see soft tyres. We'll see more action. It'll be worth tuning in, as we'll Inside the Paddock tomorrow, where we'll have a working gimbal for you. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow.